town business by the town board. The public is invited to participate at the items marked on the agenda, public comment. During that segment of the meeting, if you have a question or comment for the supervisor, please raise your hand and wait to be acknowledged. Please state your full name and limit your remarks to 3 minutes. Thank you for your anticipated cooperation.
Before we start the regular meeting, I'd like to make everybody aware we're still in a public hearing on the tow code. I'd like to close that public hearing and leave written comments open. So could I have a comment for that, a motion for that?
I'll make the motion.
Need a second?
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
So moved. I'd like to start the meeting with the Pledge of Allegiance, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. A moment of silence for two veterans that the town of Marlborough passing. Mr. Onesco, who fought in World War II, Mr. Graziosi, who was in the Korean War and was wounded, also a town employee. And we also ask to protect our soldiers, especially those in armed ways. Thank you very much. I'd like to make a few amendments to the agenda. One is to add the new business telecommunications and public rights of way management law. Also, the MS4 report. And also for presentation, Ron Blass, our attorney, is here and he's gonna walk us through the resolutions today for the Newburg Water contract.
You said you were going to subtract this.
Can I have a motion on that?
I'll make a motion.
Can I have a second, please?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Motion to approve minutes for the October 10, 2016 public hearing.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So moved. Motion to approve minutes for the October 24th, 2016 town board meeting.
Motion.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Motion to approve minutes from the October 24th, 2016 public hearing.
I make the motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Authorized payment of bills in the amount of $187,077.15. Need a motion?
A motion.
Need a second?
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any comments on the agenda? Since there's no comments on the agenda? Mark is back.
He hasn't been here for so long. I don't think you should let him comment.
Yes.
Can you explain a little bit about that in
yes.
detail?
Yes.
Not in detail. I have two other questions. Should I save those for later?
Excuse me?
Should I save them for later?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. During the resolution, you can ask a question.
No, I have two other different questions.
Yeah, sure. You want to ask another question?
Should I do it now or later?
It doesn't have anything to do with any of the agendas, what he's saying.
Later.
Okay.
Thank you. So, Ron, you want to? We have the resolutions in front of us, the board.
Which ones? Yes, thank you, Supervisor. The board has several resolutions which result from the culmination of the contract negotiations with the town of Newburg with respect to a 40-year water agreement to provide a source of filtered water. After it leaves the aqueduct. The first resolution you have before you is a negative declaration under SEAKER with respect to the water agreement itself. And the next resolution you have before you is to establish a public hearing on November 28th to approve the capital acquisition of the reservation of treated water supply capacity from Newburgh at the costs disclosed within a map plan and report, which will be the subject of public hearing.
So, Ron, should we do the resolution and then
call me to
poll the board?
Sure.
Like
so
Resolution 102, which you just explained about the neg deck?
Okay.
Okay, Colin? Could you poll the board, please, on Resolution 102? Yes.
Councilman Molinelli?
Yes.
Councilman Corcoran?
Yes.
Councilman Kingery?
Yes.
And Resolution 103 is,
That's not it.
Sorry, 102. Where were we going there, Ron?
103 is to set a public hearing on November 28th for the capital acquisition of the water supply capacity.
That's not what it says.
Yeah, it says notice of public hearing on the
end. I see at the end, okay.
Yes, at the end.
Okay.
Do you want to read that, Ron? That public hearing statement?
Public hearing notice?
Yeah, please.
Okay. So the notice of public hearing is take notice that the town of Marlborough will meet for the purposes of conducting a public hearing on what I guess will be November 28th.
Yes.
At the town hall. At 7 p.m. With respect to a map plan and report of Brunier and Larios dated November of 2016, which is on file with the town clerk, and which addresses an expenditure of the maximum sum of $3,510,784 to acquire by intermunicipal agreement between the Marlborough Water District and the town of Newburgh, an agreement to create a minimum reserve capacity of treated public water supply of 800,000 gallons per day, payable in the amount of $883,992 upon the effective date of the water agreement, followed by subsequent annual sums approximating $175,000 for the period 2017 through 2031, as stated with greater specificity in the capital payment schedule annexed to the water agreement, which forms a part of the map plan and report. The intermunicipal agreement also provides an option for the Marlborough Water District to acquire additional reserve capacity at additional cost as set forth within the map and plan and report. At the aforesaid time and place, the town board will hear all persons interested in the subject thereof concerning the same.
Colleen.
Supervisor Lanzetta.
Yes.
Councilman Molinelli.
Yes.
Councilman Corcoran.
Yes.
Councilman
Kinney. Yes.
The next resolution is Resolution 104 to establish and to fund a new capital reserve account for the Marlborough Water District for the purposes of payment for the capital acquisition of reserved water supply capacity from the town of Newburgh. And that capital reserve fund will be funded by a transfer of funds from another capital reserve fund of the Marlborough Water District, which does not any longer have a purpose for the town. The resolution basically provides for the, I don't have the board has the copy of the resolution with the dollar amount of the
yes.
current capital reserve account. Set up in 1993.
It's $1,041,268.58.
So the purpose of this resolution is to create a new capital reserve account to take in that money by transfer and to apply it to the costs of the Newburgh Water Agreement. And that resolution will be subject to permissive referendum.
Colleen?
Supervisor Lanzetta?
Yes.
Councilman Molinelli?
Yes.
Councilman Corcoran?
Yes.
Councilman King.
Yes.
And the last of the resolutions on this topic is number 105, which is a simple resolution authorizing the supervisor to sign the negotiated water agreement with the town of Newburgh.
Coming.
Supervisor Lanzetta.
Yes.
Councilman Molinelli.
Yes.
Councilman Corcoran.
Yes.
Councilman King.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Ryan. First of all, I want to thank you very much for being persistent on this. We worked very hard on it, and we finally, I mean, it's 2011, we finally got it done, so a great job to you and Mr. Valerio.
Thank you for your help.
Thank you.
Because I know that you personally put to bed a couple of the issues, if not more than a couple.
Thank you very much. And Gil from the town of Newburgh.
Yes.
He was very gracious.
He was very helpful, too.
Worked very good with us. So, and thank the board.
Yeah.
So, that being said, I make a motion to go into executive session, so Mr. Blass could take us up. It shouldn't take too long, two contracts with Verizon. One is the node, and one is the one on the water tower.
I'll make that motion for, we go into executive for contractual.
Need a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I apologize to the people out there, it should be very brief. Although, with a lawyer.
Should say 28, right?
Yeah, I'll tell them to change that.
I was gonna say.
They need to amend that because, yes, it's supposed to say 28.
It seems like the problem, people want a job and they just have no clue exactly. You know how many people apply here to one of the police officers who's never worked a day in a police career?
Yeah.
No certifications, no more.
They think they're interested in that farm. Yeah, say it. You know, mindset around town. And mindset of a lot of people is, it's only the mindset. I don't know why I have to.
No liability to do.
Yeah, nah.
You don't drive big trucks or.
What are you doing?
There is.
Driving crazy.
I
Our generator's broken. Is it attached to our?
He might have a generator.
I would have a generator?
That's true.
Right? You don't have a pump? Water hammer, don't got a pump? There you go, you just gotta get garden hose. I got a 100 feet of it. Bring that in, Brad. He's got a pump, he's got a generator. I got a 100 feet of garden hose.
We have a hose hole.
Brand new and a roll still.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, my father.
I wish I was like that. Perfect. You got one. Why don't we have one for one? Just borrow from Charlie now.
He needs it for a couple hours.
To mix cement?
He just needs water to mix the cement. It was in our contract to dig the holes and mix cement. Since we didn't get to it, I ordered the cement today. It's there today. Later, it'll be there. No, I gotta be mixed. He's gonna mix them. He'll put them back, so just have the water. He'll man mix them. He'll put them in the holes. Yeah, that was supposed to be our deal. But he's doing it for us, so now he's getting them washed. You know, we were supposed to have this.
When is this supposed to be happening?
Next couple days. He wants to start erecting the thing on Friday. So if it doesn't rain tomorrow, he'll send the guy to work, put the concrete in by Thursday or Friday, so it's up.
And the benefits would be so enticing.
100 feet of holes out back here too.
You got holes all over.
Back here too.
I thought about one and then two, but one we have to count two. A short load would be, I mean, I know, but still lots of minimum, I think. You don't have a minimum? Yeah, I imagine, yeah. Because of concrete. I just wouldn't know. I thought about it. I don't know how to pay him. I don't know if he's gonna wait 30 days. Does he wait 30 days for the?
Why can't he voucher? Yeah, you voucher.
Still with that?
That would make your life easier. Why don't you do that? Just let him voucher. Tell him it's going to take a while. He'll get paid. We're not going to stiff him. That'd be better.
I didn't know he'd do it for us. He's worked for you before. He's worked for the town before, but I guess it's not wrong. As long as I could get him up at the house, he couldn't get me in for like a week and a half. Walkways, he was so pissed at.
Yeah, this is different if you're doing holes.
Can he get his truck to it?
Yeah, with those chutes, he could come right on that backside. He should have enough chutes to get across the. Yeah, he can back up to the court one. I don't know if the chutes will go across one and two. He's got 9 holes on the hill. Or 8 holes. Yeah, that's what he's doing. I'll see if Trizali has the people take it back.
Why wouldn't they?
It was on the shelf. I had like a special order.
Right.
Just took it off the shelf.
Tell me, you're going a different way, an easier way.
All right, you know, if he can do it, then we'll just do it that way. I know the kid. I just used him.
Oh, Art Moody? Adrian's son?
No, no, I mean, I'm good with that. I didn't think he would hold paper for us in town. All right, well, if he's done it for you, then he's okay with working for the town, then I guess.
thought Staples, I thought Cindy got something. Yeah, like a blanket kind of credit card you can use for any place. No, that would be a lot easier. You're right. They probably have loopholes. Oh, is that what it is? Really? Supervisor should. Yeah, definitely.
We're just laying it down.
I mean, what's the difference?
6 inches each, just so he has a footer.
Well, I think we have enough time to cover.
All right, that's good to know then.
I think that would be rectified. Right, our petty cash fund, right. Make a sideboard.
That's what I think, I see how busy it is.
And then let Chris reimburse us when they need something else, and put it back into it, like $500 or something.
You go right tomorrow, you come tomorrow.
More would be better, but. Money, he knows he'll get it.
Well, that's how we did it. Yeah, the house, even that squeezed me in. I had to wait a week, but it squeezed me in. It was like, I'll call you like an hour before because I don't know what I got. I'm like, dude, come anytime you want. I don't care. You know, I'm on the fly. Supply, the guy was supposed to come tomorrow and he was going to hand fix it, he was going to put it in the holes. It didn't matter. If I was doing it, I was going to do it, believe it. Yeah. That'll work. I'll try to do it.
Sounds like a plan.
No, hold on. If I need to call you by lunchtime.
That's good. What time is it?
7:29. Okay. Now, could you make the motion back in session and back in regular meeting?
Yeah. I make a motion that we come out of executive session and re-enter back into the regular monthly meeting.
I'll second it.
No decisions were made.
No decisions were made.
Thank you. Okay.
Excuse me for 1 second.
Yes.
Mark Reynolds pointed out on resolution number 103, paragraph 3, that it says the public hearing should be held on November 14th, and it really should say 28th. So we can amend that to say November 28th.
It says November 28th on the top. What does
no,
it say?
No, on the.
Yeah, the aforesaid hearing
could you change
shall
that?
Be held.
Thank
yes.
you.
On the bottom.
Thank
the
you
bottom,
for picking that
yep.
up.
So if we could just.
I make a
motion.
A motion.
It's nice to have you back, Mark. Thanks
Mark.
James, I'm disappointed in you, James.
You
didn't pick that
I
up.
Usually catch that stuff.
Yeah, because the notice of the public hearing is on November the 28th.
Okay. That's all.
Thank you very much. So we'll start with the reports. So before I start with my report, Mark, did you see this pamphlet about the Town of Marlborough Local Waterfront Revitalization Program and Comprehensive Plan Public Information Meeting? Could you possibly put that in the, huh? Yeah. I put them up all over the town, and it's on the website. So a supervisor report for November 2016. I met with Councilman Corcoran and police and health insurance representatives to discuss the new insurance plan. Attended a meeting with employees and MVP representatives to discuss health care. Attended a meeting at the Wallace Center in High Park with Rosemary Wine on increasing access for people with physical challenge to our parks. Attended the Hudson River Greenway meeting at the Wallace Center in High Park. Participated in the town recreation with the Trunk or Treat, which is really great. Met with Councilman Koenig and members of the Milton Landing Committee and DEC Extuary Representative to discuss peer grant. Met with the Lloyd Supervisor, Paul Hansett, and Chief Kokoza to discuss proposed towing law. Attended a regional conference on preserving the landscape of the Hudson Valley. Met with Councilman Corcoran and Central Hudson Gas representatives to discuss line the gas line along 9W with Chestnut Petroleum Project on Route 9W. That was very interesting. We went there. The line actually is like 500 PSI. So if that's the main transmission line. So if you were to build a house and you wanted natural gas, it would probably cost you around $40,000 to hook up, because they have to bring that pressure down. They have to actually have a station there to bring it down into your house. So that was informative. And we found out that you really can't go to the east at that site. So it was informative. Had the honor to represent the town at the Marlborough, at Town of Marlborough, at the Town Veterans Observance at the Town Memorial on Route 9W. Met with John Alonji and Gail Appler and the chief, King Street signage. We had that moved. And thank you, Gail, for helping us out with that. And also, Gail, you were instrumental in getting those big arrows to go either north or south. So that's working out very good. And a public information meeting that I just gave Mark is on the 17th from 6:30 to 8:30 at the Marlborough Elementary School cafeteria. Thank you. Next.
Tommy, you got a report?
Tommy Corcoran.
Tommy Corcoran. Hi, Tom.
Month of October 2016, building inspector's monthly report. Certificate of occupancy 1, request for information 15. Building extensions 5, fire inspections 6. Stop work orders 1, order to remedy 16. Complaints 31. Burn permits issued 15. Building permits 30. 2 one family, 1 electrical, 1 furnace, 3 demolitions, 1 tank, 1 hot tub, 3 sheds, 2 roofs, 2 signs, 3 additions, 1 commercial structure, 5 decks, 1 pole barn, 2 carports, and 2 solar panels. Estimated cost of buildings, $2,007,499. Total monthly receipts, certificate of occupancy, 150. Request for information, 1,500. Building extensions, 900. Building permits, $5,249.40. Fire inspection fees, 480. For a monthly total receipt of $8,279.40. Total gas usage, 69 gallons. Total miles, 1,113.
Thanks, any questions for Tom?
No.
Thank you, Tom. Great Tom. Job.
Thanks for picking up those signs, too.
Chief Kokoza.
Activity summary for the month of October 2016. Personal injury auto accidents 2, fatal 0, property damage accidents 16, for a total of 18 for the month. Summons is issued, vehicle and traffic 343, parking violations 13. Complaint activity, total blotters 350, total arrests 42. Telephone calls handled is 1,703 calls. Overtime, full-time dispatcher, 8 hours. Part-time dispatcher, 40 hours. Police mileage, 13,380 miles, with a consumption of 1,105.717 gallons. Submit it.
Yeah, those parking tickets, were most of them down by King Street?
King Street and Dock Road.
Oh, for Falco's place, yeah, that way? The other question I had for you, I mean, it's amazing, you guys quadrupled your summonses from last year.
Yep.
So, anything, reason for that, or?
In 16, we had two forms of DWI enforcement. We had what we called holiday funding in the term of $15,000, in which we did DWI enforcement in specific periods around the holidays. There was 14 of them.
Mm-hmm.
And then regular DWI money, which is the last month we a huge push on our DWI money because we have to use it by a certain date. Hence, the more they work for the purpose of writing tickets, the more tickets we get, mm-hmm. which reflects in our numbers for the total year. Some months low, some months really high. It all evens out, though.
Okay.
But we did very well.
No, you're 400 for the year above mm-hmm. last year.
Very good. You know, a bunch of young guys. They're energetic. And good. Works out well. I also have the dog control okay. officer's report that I'll read.
Eric, before you go, I have a question on, I'm looking at the budgetary numbers we're at, and I see that the part-time were like double at this point, but the full-time were...
What do you understand?
We got more holidays to come, but full-time holiday pay and part-time holiday pay, whereas the part-time holiday pay were already double what we budgeted, but the full-time were like...
So what will end up happening is, normally what ends up happening is we're well over budget in a full-time holiday because we have to budget for that, like they're going to work every holiday. So that's right. why that number comes out. What ends up happening is they end up taking the time off, so you don't pay them the double time and a half. They just get the 8 hours holiday pay. So that usually outweighs the part-time. So even though we're doubled what we budget for the part-time guy, it'll still even out once we get... pull it from the part-time, the full-time line.
So you don't anticipate using that whole $29,300 in the full-time?
No, that number is derived from multiplying the number of full-timers. We look at a calendar, figure out what days the holidays fall on. Then we assume the full-timer is going to work those holidays if it's a Monday through Friday holiday. Right. We then do the math on what it costs a double time, and have to come up with that number. We have to do that because the full-timer has the opportunity to work the holiday. So we have to do worst-case scenario with that.
All right.
Fortunately for us, so like Christmas Eve and Christmas fall on Saturday, Sunday. Those are regular days off for the full-timers. Therefore, they'll only get their eight-hour holiday pay. They won't make double time and a half, unlike Veterans Day, which was a Friday.
Mm-hmm.
So the two B-line guys, the three C-line guys, and the two A-line guys, all full-timers, all made double time and a half for that day. So you have to budget it, worst-case scenario. It'll even out. We're probably going to have leftover money in those lines because even though we've doubled the part-timer holiday line, it still doesn't equal what we would have paid the full-timer, so it'll transfer over.
Yeah, so those, hopefully, I mean, that's my thing. You don't think we're going to use all that full-time then? So.
No. No,
and then
I don't think
we've got the same kind of scenario with the full-time shift coverage.
Yep.
We're already over, and the part-time shift coverage we're under, so.
It tends to even out.
Those should even
pretty
out,
close.
You believe?
It's the way it's been in years past, so I suspect it's going to go the same way this year. We don't have much left. What do we have, 6 weeks left of payroll?
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Any other questions for the chief?
Okay. Andrew McKee's monthly report, October 2015. We received a total of 21 calls this month, including 21 calls of service for the Marlborough Police Department, State Police, and Ulster County Sheriff. Responded to 4 active complaints and or cases which are now closed or resolved. We currently have 2 open cases that have been addressed but are ongoing and unresolved. We impounded 1 stray dog which was redeemed by its owner. There was 1 dog bite report for the month. We currently have no dogs in the kennel. We have 1 case in the Marble Justice Court at this time. And we are continuing research regarding some additions and changes we would like to make to the town code, and we'll present that material to the town board as soon as we have a draft. Andrew McKee.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Highway Superintendent Mr. Gail Appler, Senior. How you doing, Gail?
Very well, Al, thank you. All right, monthly report for October 2016. Roads, we repaired the road cut on Bellissimo with hot asphalt and the help of Town of Platicille's paver. We also repaved the south end of Grand Street, and we did a litter patrol and picked up 10 bags on Gabberty Lane. We removed the line of shrubs on South Street that impacted traffic and sight distance. Drainage, we continue cleaning and inspecting the 558 catch basins throughout the township. We also had two men repainting the catch basin markers on the roadways. And we repaired a ditch line on Old Post Millhouse Road, and we opened up the catch basins on Vineyard Lane, and we cleaned the ditch line on Idlewild and Pioneer. Snow and ice on 1027, we had a light snowstorm. About 1 p.m., we had a truck out to salty up higher elevations, but temps started to rise later, and we had no more problems, although some parts of the county had to plow. Water Department, we repaved Water Department road cuts on Platicille and on Main Street in Milton. Landfill, we repaired the potholes on a landfill entrance road and loaded some heavy metals into the bin. Fuel usage, gas 468 gallons, diesel 554.
Any questions for Mr. Appin?
Nope.
How you making out with your, you're down a few people, huh? How's that? Yeah, any ideas?
Oh, the two people?
You're down a few
very
people.
Shortly, yeah. Well,
okay, good. I know it's like going into the snow season. You don't want to be down.
Yeah, yeah. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Majeo.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Monthly report for October. Water consumption totaled 14.7 million gallons. That is a daily usage of 473,000 gallons a day, compared to last month, which we had 14.9 million gallons. That is a daily usage of 498,000 a day, compared to a year ago, which was 14.5 million gallons for the month, which is a daily usage of 467,000 gallons. The summary for the month, we had service lines. We repaired service lines on Orchard Street and Platicille Road, hydrants. We repaired hydrants on Milton Turnpike and Platicille Road and Youngs Avenue. We also started flushing hydrants. Water mains, we had to repair an 8-inch water main on Platicille Road. We also had to repair road cuts from water main damage with the help of the Highway Department. The town park, we winterized the town park for the season. Bills went out, and we had to alleviate calls about high water bills. Service line inspection, we have one, closings four, markouts 20, gallons of gas used 206, gallons of diesel zero, and the mileage for the month was 1,200.
Charlie, I notice Brooklyn Bottling is using some excess water, or I saw some voucher today related to that.
That's been because for our over usage from New York City,
okay.
We have an agreement with them that they have to pay
right.
85% of that bill.
Okay.
So, but we haven't had one since August. New York City's a little bit behind on their billing, so
okay.
They should be all right for the next 2 months.
Okay.
Thanks, Charlie.
You're any welcome. Questions, Charlie?
You know, I have, not for you, Charlie. How's it going now? That's three different departments now that using the gas. How do you see a difference in savings with the going with the school and the price?
In fuel?
Yes.
It's been going pretty good, actually.
No, I know, going pretty good, but have we seen any savings? I thought we were going to get savings.
I think regardless we're going to see savings.
Well, we will. I mean, I haven't actually pulled everything to see what the numbers are.
Yeah.
But
I'd just like to know what that is.
I'd like to get a full year at the end of this year.
Yeah.
That would be a good thing to see. You're absolutely. But, I mean, right, Gail, it's been pretty good, the fueling down there. We haven't had any real incidents, right?
So not really.
The guy's been coming and filling up. So
I'm just wondering what
I understand what you mean.
But that's a good point. We should see what the actual savings is over a year.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. You're going to see a cost saving.
That's it.
Yeah, he's filling up a tractor trailer load at a time. So.
Right,
yeah. Yeah, we can't get the tractor.
Yeah. I mean,
And we also, we also save money on basically not having to pay out the money. We're keeping our money in the bank.
Maybe better than we used to do.
Yeah.
We might be saving some money.
Anyway. Well, that's what I'd like to see.
Find out.
I'll check that out. Colleen, our town clerk. How are you, Colleen?
Good, and yourself?
Good, thank you.
Good. Town clerk monthly report for October 2016. Conservation, 16 for $72.43. Dog licenses, 26 for a total of $155. Transfer station permit, 1 for $30. Punch cards, 30 for $1,855. Marriage licenses, 4 for $70. Building fees, 1 for $14,273. Fire fees, 1 for $640. Zumba, 2 for $251. Accident reports, 23 for $115. Certified copies, 4 for $100. Dog warden fees, 1 for $256.50. Foils, 1 for $1.25. Minor sales, 3 for $3,175.50. For a grand total of $20,994.68.
Thank you, Colleen. Thanks. Any questions for Colleen? Thank you, Colleen.
Thank you, Colleen.
Scott, could you read Mr. Falcone's report, please?
Wastewater Quality Management, November 14th, 2016. Report on the Marlborough Wastewater Treatment Plant for the month of October 2016. The average flow to the plant was 94,000 gallons per day. The process is working well, removing 99% of BODs and 98% of suspended solids. Milton Wastewater Treatment Plant, the average flow in the Milton plant during October 2016 was 33,000 gallons per day. Process is working well, removing 99% of BOD and 90% of suspended solids. Overall, both water treatment plants are in good working order. The New York State DEC annual inspection report for both Marlborough and Milton plants requested that we get alarm systems working at the plants. Both systems had alarms that were installed when built, but these are no longer working. I will look into the cost of repair of installing new systems and advise. The collection system is being monitored and maintained by Charlie Maggio in the Water Department. If you need any additional information, please do not hesitate to contact me, Tony Falco, Water Quality Management.
Thank you, Scott. Next is the assessor. Our office processed 16 real property transfers. We mailed out the annual renewal exemption application for the Enhanced Star, aged exemption, agricultural exemption, and nonprofit exemptions. We have been steadily processing them as we receive them back in. We have been continuing our collection of new construction and splits and mergers. And that's from Cindy Hilbert. Thank you, Cindy.
Okay, I have Chris Brands. I guess it's 2 months he's given me here.
Okay.
Looks like I have October. Attendees were Chris Brand, Manny Kauke, Stephen Clark, Cindy Lanzetta, Joe LaFaro, and Ben Trapani. On the agenda, they approved the stenographer minutes from 9/6/16 and 9/9/16. The approval of the above minutes were unanimously approved. I guess Empire Landscaping, which is our statement, you're going to first for that. Conditional final approval was granted. Conditions include adopting the Ulster County Planning Board's recommendations to expand the driveway from its current 16-foot width to 20-foot width to accommodate two-way traffic and ensure emergency response vehicles will have adequate access to the site. Additional conditions include the Town of Marlborough Town Board adopting an amended resolution as this parcel requires approval to meet the designation standards of the business corridor overlay district. So I guess we get close on that.
Yep.
Chestnut Petroleum, site plan, technical review. Comments were presented by Patrick Hines. Issues were included, revisions of plans to indicate Route 9W access points and 9W corridor improvements. Future health department approvals, internal circulation and delivery truck access, water main clarification with affected adjacent property owners, visual screening of dumpster enclosures, water main service connections, handicap accessibility, gutter discharge, and updating engineering drawings. And we got more. Members of the planning board also questioned the applicant's lack of sidewalk on the plans. The applicant was encouraged to include sidewalks as they improve the safety of the foreseeable increase in pedestrian safety to and from the site and are part of the town's comprehensive plan. A public hearing was scheduled for the first meeting in December, which will be next month. I guess there was nothing for the other meeting. The next meeting was November 7th. Attendees were Chris Band, Manny Cowkey, Stephen Clark, Cindy Lanzetta, Joe LaFaro, Ben Trapani, and Joel Tricali. Agenda, the board amended the agenda and acknowledged the receipt of the proposed local law amending various portions of Chapter 155 zoning of the Marlborough Town Code. The board reviewed, acknowledged, and accepted these changes. Then they have the approval of the stenographer for the minutes of the meeting I just told you of 10:17. It was unanimously approved. Board member Joel, except Joel Tricali, abstained due to his absence. We have Tommy Corcoran III, 11 Ann's Orchard, Milton, sketch lot line revision. The applicant presented a basic lot line revision in order to make the parcel conform to local zoning regulations. The LLR sketch was granted preliminary approval. A public hearing was scheduled for November 21st. Okay, this is not an Italian name, so it's a Wahid, 144 Reservoir Road, Marlborough, sketch lot line revision. The applicant presented a proposed lot line revision in order to consolidate two existing parcels into 1.907-acre parcel. Each of the parcels currently contains a single-family residential structure, one bi-level frame dwelling, and one house trailer. Consolidation of the parcel in its current condition is not allowed under the town zoning requirements. The applicant was advised to contact the office of the town code enforcement officer in order to properly demolish and or remove the trailer from the premises. The applicants were also, also advised to contact the ZBA office to seek an additional variance since the property would require before consolidation could be granted. Christopher Larkin, Diego Extension. The applicant sent a letter seeking approval to extend the conditional approval originally granted on 4/21/2014. A motion was made but not seconded, so I guess it didn't go through. Ryan DiStefano, 1989 Route 9W, Marlborough. Discussion without attorney, engineer, or stenographer. The applicant presented a comprehensive plan to open and operate a proposed firearms and ammunition retail store in a currently unused portion of this commercial property. As the proposal meets all the necessary requirements needed to operate at this location, the applicant was advised to submit a revised site plan for the board to review. Next deadline for the meeting is November 11th to get in, and the next scheduled meeting is Monday, November 21st, 2016. And this was submitted respectfully, Chris Brand, Chairman, Town of Marlborough Planning Board.
Well done, Ed.
Thank you very much. You can have that.
Thank you. Thank you for doing that.
No problem.
Appreciate it. So I think we got everybody's report this year.
Yes, we did. Good job, Al.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Okay, moving along, report of the committees. Recreation Committee. Chief, you just want to say something about briefly what happened in Milton on Halloween or the day before? It was a Saturday or Sunday.
The Sunday, the community day?
Yeah.
Community day went very well. It was widely attended.
Can you hear me now? So community day went very well. It was widely attended. We're guessing between 300 and 400 people showed up since we cooked all 350 hamburgers and people looking for food. So we're going to assume that. Even though it rained, it was still very well attended. We had a good time. People had a good time. It worked very well with Trunk or Treat being on the same day as well as the Milton Firehouse Parade. People shared all three events. We heard nice things. And we look forward to doing it again next year.
Thanks, Chief.
Yeah, it was a very good event.
Any comments?
A little rainy. One day off.
I'll split up the hamburger or something.
But it was good.
What are you going to do?
From recreation now, I just want to bring up that Tommy's still been working with AMD to get the pavilion roof put on. I know he staked it out for the bocce court. So and you're working, Gail has agreed to dig out those holes. So
Gail got the holes dug today. So hopefully tomorrow we get some concrete put in there, and he's going to start the project on Thursday or Friday.
Nice.
Thank you, Gil.
Thank
who
you,
won the bocce?
It wasn't us.
It was Mastock.
Mastock?
What do they call themselves?
Mastock Warriors.
Mastock Warriors. Lee Mazzola.
All right. And I just want to thank Tom for doing
that.
Thank you,
Tom.
Very much.
Thank you, Tom.
It's a lot of extra work.
Thank you, Tom. Thanks for also for the fence up there. I took a ride up there.
Yeah, that's good.
That should keep them off.
Hopefully.
If that doesn't keep them off, we're sending Alan up there.
I'll keep them off.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tom. Alan, anything on the emergency management?
No, I'm going to be updating the plan. There's going to be some name changes on there, but we'll work that out, and I'll have it ready for the, basically...
Reorg,
yep.
Okay. And Conservation Advisory Committee, we met, and Tom Corcoran, our building inspector, was there, and two gentlemen, and we learned a lot more about solar, and we're pretty close. Hopefully, the CAC will present their findings to the board.
Great.
And as a matter of fact, Tom, somebody called me up today, same spiel, you know.
Yeah.
I said, I didn't, you know, our terrain is pretty rough. And he says, well, he says, somebody might come in and you get 20% of the bonus, something like that. Something like we heard at the meeting, which is, I guess, good. IT committee. I can tell you that the cameras are up at the train station.
Cameras are up and running.
Yeah. Yep. Today the chief sent me a step-by-step how to get on your iPhone, and I'll send it to all the councilmen, and it's pretty cool.
Yep. If you guys have an opportunity to at least pull it up on Al's phone if you don't want to dial on your own, the view for the cameras is strictly the sides of the four sides of the building. I'd like to see if you guys would consider at least one, maybe two more cameras to look from the front two corners of the building at the train station parking lot.
Right.
I would suggest that necessary. I don't know. It probably completes our view. But we got the four. They're off and running, and they look good.
I think you may want to do one as well as the front and then also maybe the side parking lot.
Where they fish? That, where they park along the fence line?
Where that fence extends that way.
You know, I mean, the old garden.
The cameras themselves aren't the expensive part. I didn't think of that, but that's probably a really good idea because that is a spot that they park a lot.
Well, they're tucked away too. You know what
yeah.
I mean? It's like tucked in there. So.
And it's very easy. The way we mounted them on the eaves, it's very easy. When we were playing with them, trying to adjust them, we tried to figure out what would be the best, and the way we have, we think they're the best, but I'm open for suggestions. I'm not a camera expert, so.
We could revisit that.
Yeah, because I think where they had the damages was to the little shack and stuff like that, and that's kind of where people tucked in over that one. So.
Right, there's no view of that over there at all.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
Thanks, Jerry.
Thank you.
Nice. Thank you, Jerry.
And thanks, Dan. We're just about done at the... the highway, right, Gail?
Yes.
On the cameras? We're just about done there.
Yeah,
Dan's got to go down. Okay. Milton Train Station Foundation, Dan's not here, but I could tell you we're moving forward with the $150,000 grant. There was another request for more paperwork, and we just filled that out and sent. So hopefully we're getting close that we could go for an RFP on that project and finish that up. Milton Landing Citizens Committee, Al?
Yeah, I think we had a meeting with the the engineering firm that's handling the part of our grant study. I believe that went well. We had some good input. We're expecting to have some good information back shortly. And I think they want to come here. I think we thought it would be a good idea if they did a presentation here, a public presentation at a town board meeting to show exactly what direction we're going to be going in. But I'm excited about it. I really am.
Yeah, she actually sent us three renderings of the floating docks
and
stuff.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to your comment.
I'm still going through a couple things in my mind.
They're all really
They're all good, but I got a couple things I just don't want to block any kind of future growth. And also, we got the trees cut down in case any of the other board members hadn't seen that. So. It looks good, it really helped protect that building. We have to kind of maybe figure out a way to get that leaf debris off the building, though. That's the only thing I could think, because it's still a lot of debris on top of that building. And that's basically the pitch on that roof doesn't lend itself well to maybe if we get a, well, I doubt it because we've had torrential downpours and the stuff's still up there. But we
pressure washers.
Pressure washer or one heck of a leaf blower.
Charlie, you got to get Bruno up there.
That's with the infrared.
With the blower.
I mean, we got to do something. We got to figure something out because it's sitting there and it's water's building back building up on that. And that snow and ice is going to back build up on that too. So. So we have to figure something out, though. I'll figure something out.
You want to work on that, Al?
I
I could figure something out.
Okay. Marlborough Hammett Economic Development Committee met. We talked with Sheila Manisi from Meet Me in Marlborough, come up with some ideas of some different events for the town. So it was a pretty good meeting. Meet Me in Marlborough, I have, like...
Bless you.
Bless you. She was at, Sheila was at that meeting, so I know anybody got her anything from Meet Me in Marlborough.
Christmas, what is the, they have that event at the school coming up. I think it's this weekend.
It is this weekend.
The craft fair that they have every weekend at the Marlborough Elementary School?
Yep.
I believe it's this weekend, the craft, annual craft fair?
Should be on our, should have that on our website, right?
Yeah.
So they have their own website, right?
Yep.
Hammett and Milton Association Committee,
Yeah, just to tie it in, I think everyone's seen the decorations down there. Obviously, their holiday event's gonna be coming up, so keep your eyes open for that. We'll have that information on social media and some pamphlets around town. Also, we in conjunction, well, not even in conjunction, but we actually teamed up kind of with Jerry and the police department at Trunk or Treat. We did our annual, the fire department did it with the library, coordinated with the Sarah Hulick Library. Had a great little Halloween parade down there for kids in costumes. I think, Mark, you were there, I think.
Another guy,
was there. And it was another, I mean, we had, you know, some rainy weather, but I'm telling you what, we were loaded. I think we had more this year than we had last year, so it's really turned into a great event. We were able to send them up if they weren't already at Jerry's event. It kind of worked out, you know, both ways. So it was a real good event, and we look forward to doing it again next year.
Thank you, Al. So what's the board's feeling about a water committee? Should we still have a water committee or just leave it there?
Until we pass it, maybe.
Hey, I guess we have to pass it first, like Scott. Yeah, we still actually have to have the public hearing. We have a couple more meetings.
Yep. Yeah,
maybe at the reorg.
By the end of the year, the reorg should be.
Okay. Reorg, we'll answer that.
It's almost off.
And as you know, Mr. Graciosi passed away, and I haven't had a chance. I just saw Walt down at the wake. So I'll leave that up to you and Howard to discuss, see what we want to do. Is there a reason why he is, you know, if Walt could take Fridays or?
I think you're going to have to in the interim. I mean, but I don't know. I have to talk to Walt because I know he does another job. So.
Yeah.
But we definitely should have, we definitely have to put something out for an ad. We probably should motion to put an advertisement out for another part-time position.
How many hours?
It's 15 hours a week, maybe, something like that.
He used to work with Mr. Graciosi on Saturdays?
One day they worked together, the other days they split.
Yeah, when we went up there, they both worked.
They were both, that was a Saturday.
Saturday's the busiest day.
No, yeah, I was a working shift at Sunday.
Sunday. Eddie and I met him up there.
Sunday.
It was a Sunday.
They were both there then.
Yeah, it could be that they do, you know,
Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Do you want to just look at it and see what days and then get with Colleen and
the board agrees.
I think we should at least make a motion
to advertise.
Get the information from Howard.
Yeah, I'll get the information and then we'll advertise, right? I'll make a motion to advertise.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'll just diet.
If anybody knows anybody. Here we go.
Jerry knows about that.
It could be the crossing guard and the.
Yeah.
You have a double person here.
All right.
By the way, just quick though, Jerry, you haven't got anything back on the crossing guard, right?
Yes.
Got the crossing guard?
Actually, Justin Pascal has a contact with a young kid that's friends with his family. He's early 20s, who just finished phase one of the police academy, so he's jobless, basically. And he came inquiring about a dispatch job with Justin. Justin says, hey, do I have a gig for you?
What a salesman. Take a seat, kid.
He is interested in doing both dispatching and the traffic guard. We checked, we can do that as long as it doesn't exceed 40 hours, which you want to come close. I sent Councilman Morelli, Councilman Baker emails. Hopefully, we'll be doing that interview this week at some point and get it going. So
that's good.
Just
now,
good news.
Control, but, looks like we might
that looks good.
Let me ask you a question. Does he go into the part-time dispatcher union, though, by saying they don't have, there's only full-times, right?
Correct.
Yeah.
Part-time driver.
Okay. So
Anytime Wednesday's fine with me, just email me what's good for me.
Sounds good.
All right.
That's good. When does he leave, or is he gone?
He's gone.
He's gone. Okay, so you've been doing it.
Patrol, not me.
I know, patrol is.
You don't want to do it, Jay?
Why aren't you out there?
Worst job in the world. Oops, shouldn't have said that.
Okay, thank you, Jer. Old business. Anything on the sale of the Tomvac building?
Nope.
Well, the municipal parking in the Hamlet at Marlborough and Milton, I mean, we're doing the best we can. I could say that I think in Marlborough, the stripes are working out very well.
Yeah, they did it nice.
And it looks nice. It looks clean. And now with the addition of those signs to keep King Street clear of people going south and the arrows, I think, I don't know what else we can do unless somebody donates land for a parking spot. So it seems like it's working. Milton, I don't know if anybody's using the school up here on the weekends. Pretty soon I think the restaurant's going to open up. Maybe that'll help out.
It's going to be, it's going to get busy.
I
started to poke around a little bit about
parking behind that
with the business owners regarding the stretch, you know, going north to the post office, about possible one way. So I'm starting to get feedback now.
Okay.
Some good. Some.
You talk to Mr. Apple.
Yeah, no, well, I'll have a formal meeting. I'm just poking around before.
The, I don't, you know, Al, I was thinking today while I was walking down to Frieda's, is there any way we could dress that sidewalk up? I know it's, is it ours or the county's?
Which one?
The one right out in front of
I believe that's the county's. Because we always, I want to put a sidewalk from this building.
That's the county.
That's the county's?
Yeah.
I want to put a sidewalk to continue that to Stewart's, but we'd have to deal with the county on that one. But that needs to
be. I was just thinking maybe some lighting or something.
That one is beat up and.
An LED lighting or something like that.
Well, the lighting, would that fall into our jurisdiction as far as a lighting district?
I don't know.
Maybe that's something we can talk, because there should be a light in there. But this is getting dangerous as far as people walking along the shoulder. So when that sidewalk ends, because there was a young lady tonight that basically just appeared. You know what I mean?
It's pretty dark in that area, right there.
So, what's that? There isn't a shoulder. There just isn't.
We could definitely call a meet up.
So, and she, you could tell that she stayed on that side to stay walking against traffic. But, I mean, it was just, she was there. It's kind of scary. So we got it. That has to be. We have to address that next year.
You want
to
work? We'll do that.
Yeah, we'll look at.
May I suggest you guys talk to maybe Mr. Jarrington or Mary Beth, because it is a county road.
Yeah.
And I know I had brief conversations with them in the past about extending that sidewalk, just like you said, because I think it's a benefit for everybody.
Yeah.
To get that sidewalk to Stewart's, and then eventually across the street when something starts happening over there.
Yeah.
So I think that's something our county legislators should be able to help us
out. I'll reach out to them tomorrow.
Yeah,
that's
a
good idea.
They should be the people.
Thank you.
Yeah, that would be good.
Thanks, Tom.
So, thank you, Al. Proposed water agreement with Newburgh.
We got to get this thing done, this Milton School.
Yeah, Scott and I talked about this last week.
I got a report from him.
I don't know why is he taking so long? Still.
Did the report start, sorry I'm late? Or?
Yeah.
Because it's just completely stalled at this point.
Well, I think what he said was, I wish I could. Hold on one second.
Should have been in 6 months ago.
I got too much paperwork.
I can let you know I've got two interested parties across the street.
Well, I know that. That's what we're talking about.
They're not going to make an offer. Not knowing.
I know there's people railing to start building over there, but they can't do it until they get a sewer extension.
Yeah. I mean, we got to get. This is 12 months. It's been put to the back burner at this point. We were going full speed ahead, so.
Can't quite find it, but.
Well, basically, if we could just get.
He says probably spring. You know, he's about 65% done with the design. The only thing he hasn't done is the boring. And
well, what's the delay, I guess?
He said he had some emergency, let me just see if I can find it. Sorry. Technology. Come on. I don't want to delay the meeting, but...
Neither do I.
Look, let's just do it this way. Can we at least have an answer by the next meeting? Like, because...
He gave me the, I asked him, yes, I just called him up.
Okay, well then...
This thing is jammed now.
Interim of between this meeting and next, can he at least send out an email updating the board and we can discuss this at the next meeting?
Yep.
Because we really have to get moving on this. It's like 12 months we've been delayed now. It hasn't moved.
I'm kind of, I can't believe he's only 65%.
Yeah, and spring...
It's been a year.
Spring to me is a, I don't know, a little bit of an ambiguous date. What does that mean? Spring, end of February, spring? Is first of May, spring?
They're not going to do borings.
Let's just find out. Let's move forward, all right? But let's at least have a black and white answer.
Well, I mean, I've been on top of it. He sent me an email, so it's my bad that I can't find it. But the exact...
Well, we'll know next meeting. That's all.
Bring it to next meeting.
Next meeting.
Is that the only piece? Is the survey in the end of it being done?
We don't know.
That's all done.
That's all done.
Survey's done.
Survey's done.
You just got to finish the design.
The design has to be done in the RFP.
Then he's got
to
do the RFP and then we can put it out to bid.
We've got people making inquiries into it, you know, and, you know, let's not lose it.
But I mean, if we had that and we had the RFP, then it's something you tell the people that we got this, it's ready to go. It's just a matter, we got to wait till the weather.
But I am correct.
Yep.
We're going to bond it, and then they're going to pay the bond.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's all been done.
Yeah, that's all been done.
That's all done.
Yep. So anybody I talk to, they're going to know that when they purchase the property, they're going to be part
it's
of
absolutely,
the bond.
It's back from the state comptroller. Okay. Everything's green.
Yeah, they got to pay one half of the cost of the whole project, which is approximately, what, in the $200,000 range right now?
Yeah, everything's
220,
done,
I think, is the number.
The design and the RFP.
Okay.
You know? I apologize again. I did print it out, but then again.
Okay. All right. No, that's fine.
I'll send it to these guys.
That's fine. Talk about it next meeting.
I might even have them come in on the 28th and do an update. Let him tell you why he's late.
It's fine.
Okay.
Bayside.
So. Bayside, they're still doing their final FEIS.
Yep.
I haven't heard anything. Oh, jeez, I wrote it down. So on the Millen extension, he says plans and specifications are 65% complete by December the 6th. So he'll be completed with the plans and specifications, except for boring, spring instruction schedule. So I'll have him come in. That's what he wrote in his email. That's what he told me. Huh. I knew I had it someplace. I kept on saying, look for it. Okay. So design stands for Route 9W Corridor Overlay. That's part of the LERPS, and we're having that meeting on the 17th. Sign law zoning changes. So there has been a change. There's three board members that had reconsidered, and they considered keeping the billboards and maybe regulating them or seeing what they can do as far as maintaining them. So if I could have a motion to, I don't know how you do this, reverse our last motion to say that we wanted to sunset the billboards for 5 years.
I'd be glad to make a motion. You guys came onto the dark side and agreed with me.
Yeah.
I'll definitely... Was that made at the meeting that I wasn't able to attend?
Yes. I was all by myself out on this side.
You stuck? All right, Eddie. High five. Yeah, I took calls from some citizens.
Yeah, I gave you a phone number.
And I explained to them that I wasn't here, but we all
talked. There's a whole bunch of legality stuff, and we just didn't want to get into it. We heard a bunch of people, and, you know, we decided, it's not.
You guys knew I never was for it, and I thank you for reconsidering and thinking
would you like to make a motion that we take the sunset out of the...
I'll make a motion that we take the sunset laws for the billboards out of the sign law zoning changes that we have.
I'll second that motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you, Eddie.
Thank you.
Let me ask a question on that.
Yeah.
Okay, so within the written portion of it, again, I'm okay with all that, but are we going to put pre-existing grandfathering stage?
Yes.
Right, there's not going to be any
new ones. Not going to be any new ones.
Okay.
Yeah.
No new ones. There's going to be another whole clause in it.
Yeah, I think we're going to
rewrite a section saying
right.
Pre-existing stays under certain conditions.
Yeah. And they have to be, and you're going to maintain a certain way.
Yes, maintain a certain way, certain color, certain. Not you.
You're going to be the one that's going to write them up.
I was going to say it's my assistant that you're hiring.
No. You're going to write them up, though.
Well, you're going to inspect it.
There's going to be a criteria that they're going to have to meet, that they're going to have to follow, Tom. And you'll be able to enforce it. That's what we're going to give you teeth to enforce.
We've got to give enforcement to this law as far as what the billboards are going to look like, maintain. And it's probably going to be a fee associated with it, but we've got to check legality of what we can and can't do.
Exactly. And I'm already looking on the New York State website, and they have a whole bunch of stuff on billboards, how to regulate them and stuff like that.
So nothing new. We're just going to regulate what we have.
Everything else except for the billboards we're going to
No new billboards.
And it'll be in black and white, and you can enforce it.
Right. So I talked to Milton Train Station Grants moving forward. And the tow truck law is moving forward.
Mm-hmm.
We're waiting for legality, I guess, one tow truck. Would you like to talk about that meeting?
Yes, the meeting was very, very positive. We had a lot of suggestions. Chief wrote everything down, correct? And then we have one lawyer representing one of the tow companies, and he was going to email his suggestions to the chief. I don't know if you've gotten them yet, Chief. Okay, so we need to probably just follow up with that and see when he's going to send it.
I called her today. She didn't return.
Okay. But anyway, he was willing to forward it to, and Rebecca Vaughn get involved and see what we can do to streamline everything so everybody's happy with what we got there. Okay. But they're happy with most of the stuff. It's little ditzy stuff that really, it didn't matter, you know. I think it went really well. I think the people came in there with an idea that we were really trying to do something terrible, and then after we explained why we were doing certain things, they sort of agree with most of what we had to say.
Silly little things.
Yeah, nothing major.
Protect our purpose.
Nope.
Oh, great job. Thank you, Ed.
Oh, thank you for letting me
involve. In regards to the toll law, it's somewhat obscure from the toll law itself, but I don't know if we've addressed the signs coming into town about the parking on the roads. When Mr. Cerrone's supervisor made a mistake on those signs when he erected those and purchased those, when it says, no parking, you will be towed on town roads. Again, that exempts parking in the hamlet because that's a county road.
County road.
So I don't know if there's a legality that needs to be addressed in those signs. I brought that up with the last supervisor, that those signs are incorrect, and I don't want to see a technicality from towing cars on county and state roads.
I got to look.
What's up, yeah.
What's happening?
The signs that are up are for the town. The county has the same rules for a county road, even though they're not posted. And the state has the same rules for state roads, even though they're not posted.
Okay.
The town has to post. You can check with the county if you want to see what their policy is on it, but it's no parking on the roads. And basically, if somebody parks on a highway right away during a snowstorm, that infringes on the travel of the plows open and the roads go to the public, they're not covered by insurance. Not covered by our insurance, they're not covered by their insurance. So if one of my accidentally takes the mirrors off and hits them, should not be on the road during the snowstorm.
I just had an attorney ask me the question. Well, I think he was telling me the answer. That when they say no parking, your car will be towed if on a town road, instead of no parking during on the roads in the town of Marlborough. Because the town road is specific on the signs to say a town road.
Yeah.
Again, I'm just asking. I don't care if it doesn't affect me, but those signs, I asked about those signs when he addressed that with me last year.
But I think if somebody's illegally parked on any road in the town, we enforce,
That's correct, but the signs had to be posted. That was the original issue. When we towed somebody in town, the signs weren't posted on the entrances to town. So when Supervisor Cerrone did that, I was told that the wording was incorrect. It said that on the town roads, it should be on the town roads of the town of Marlborough instead of on all town roads.
tomorrow.
Take a picture of the sign. Again, those signs went up because of reactionary to a lawsuit based on a car being towed in the town. And he put town roads instead of all roads in the town of Marlborough. So again, that brought up the issue of Western Avenue. If you're legally parked on Western Avenue, you're not legally parked on the town road. You're illegally parked on a road in the town of Marlborough, which is a county road.
Gotcha.
It was okay. Reactionary, you know.
That's lawyer and super jab, right? Lawyers.
Okay. So moving forward. Thank you, Tom. Thank you, Gail. New business, I added the telecommunication and public rights of way management law, and that had to do with the node that we talked about.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I'd like to make a motion to put that on new business.
Motion.
All in favor?
Second.
Aye.
Okay, thank you. Correspondence.
It's light today.
Yeah, really light.
Yeah, they don't use
unless you've been doing a great
that's
job.
That's because they don't use the park in the way.
Yeah, nobody needs a free
so,
park.
So this is a letter from John T. Amadeo, 29 Birchill Avenue. Dear Mr. Lanzetta, back on 10/22/16 on a late Saturday afternoon about 4 p.m., I had an issue with the plumbing at a two-family tenant house of mine. I had to shut the main water valve in the house to fix the problem. When turning the water back on, the valve broke in the closed position. I needed the main shut so I could replace the valve. Knowing the town service are closed on the weekend, I was able to leave a message with the water department. I thought I could possibly get some help first thing on Monday morning. To my surprise, not only did Mr. Charlie Majeo call me back, but he also came out to shut the main and made sure water was restored for the two families. On behalf of myself and my tenants, I'd like to extend my appreciation and thanks to Charlie and the water department for going beyond what I would have expected to restore our water. Great job, guys. John T. Amadeo. Way to go, Charlie.
Thanks, Charlie.
Good job, Charlie. Good job, Charlie.
These are the correspondence we like to see.
Yes, we do.
Yes.
Okay. Public comment. Mark?
Every seven of our tow truck drivers were there, myself, Chief Kakoza, and Howard Baker. Six represented themselves, tow truck drivers, and one tow truck driver was represented by a lawyer.
Is there a way to get hold of the names of those tow guys?
Yes.
Tow list.
Yeah, tow list. Jerry can get them to you.
Very nice.
Yep.
The other question I had was, the school had
no, it's all preliminary. There's no lawsuits filed. There's not even talk of any lawsuits. What happened was they hired an engineer, and the engineer looked at the scope of the work and what Bayside was proposing, and they made some minor changes to facilitate the bus loading and unloading and the people that were bringing their kids to load and unload. So they did a proposal, a concept drawing, and that's it. They send that to Mazur. I have not heard anything about that, as far as I know. I've asked. So they're in correspondence with the consultant for Bayside, and their engineers are talking. So sooner or later, we're going to have to go to the table and see what Mr. Sessman evaluated, what he would like to do there. And that's it. So it's moving forward. I haven't heard any, like I said, any correspondence other than that from the school, from Mr. Brooks, or from Patrick. I think we don't. I know that the insurance, our insurance picked up a majority of it. I know that the town was liable for like $5,000 to pay, but most of the other expenses were all picked up by the insurance. I think it's settled, so I think it's from public knowledge.
Okay, I'll follow up with you next week on that. And when you get to the issue of the budget, will you talk about how much is left in the fund balance?
Excuse me?
When you get to the budget, will you talk about what's left in the fund balance after you apply?
I don't know what's left in the fund balance. That probably would come at the beginning of next year sometime because, you know, bills, like our lawyers sometimes are 3 months behind. So we won't know what's left in the fund balance after paying down $175,000.
All right. Thanks.
You're welcome. James?
One of the biggest employers in the town is the school district. And what I would like to ask the board is that when they have public hearings, public meetings on the comprehensive master plan for the town, that they do it on a night that is not also a night that the school board is having one of their meetings, which is usually on Thursday night.
Well taken. It's Thursday, but the 17th.
Yes, that's what I'm saying is, in the future, it would be nice if we did not have them on a Thursday when they have their meetings.
Well, it's all logistics, right? It's logistics. If we do that, then we'll never have a meeting because every night there's something going on with certain people, right? Either it's court night or town board night or planning board night. I mean, we go along with our consultants tell us, and this is the way we try to plan. So we did get the school on the 17th. That's another thing. So what's the availability of different areas that we want to go where we could have a public hearing? So all that, you should know that, James. But take in consider your thinking about other than a Thursday, I'll consider that.
Thank you.
Okay.
Ralph has his hand up.
Ralph, how are you, Ralph?
Just as a point of information, the school board regular meetings are the first and third Thursday.
Opposite of us.
I don't believe there's anything the second and fourth Thursday of the month, and you might want to consider using those Thursdays.
I think
so. Are you saying that because they're the biggest employers in town, we should change our meeting public hearing?
Yeah, I mean that doesn't make any sense.
Are you telling me teachers are going to show up to this LWRP meeting because they don't go to school board meetings? What are you trying? What was this whole comment about?
We outreach to everybody. I mean, the Bolton says, I agree with Al. I mean, I go to the school board meetings. I mean, other than if it's where student of the year, it's you got all the parents. But other than that, you just got seven, eight board members there.
Yeah. So nobody's missing.
And I've never seen them at anything besides the board members. They're very busy people.
Yeah. So,
but I'll consider your,
but we're not going to change
your
meetings.
We're not
that's
changing
not
our
a
meetings.
Problem.
We're not changing
anyway.
Ralph's still over school doesn't run around.
Yes, Ralph.
When I stated before, it was not a question. It was just
information. And I appreciate that.
Included in any of the code, sign laws, anything, is there anything that a business
I know what you're talking about.
Like purple, it turned to green, it turned to yellow, it turned to orange.
It's in there.
He's talking about that. Talking
no
about
flashing
that.
Lights.
No flashing lights.
I know exactly what he's talking about because I put
that
an email
was taken care of pretty quick.
You see my email?
Yeah.
Are they still flashing?
No.
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 Okay.
Thank you.
They were done. That was done.
I stopped. I thought I was going to win a teddy bear if I threw rings at a bottle or something. I just saw a fish.
So,
okay.
Let's do Christmas light.
Thank you, Ralph.
All right. Thank you.
So, resolutions 102, I believe we.
Yep, we did.
103, we accomplished.
Yep.
Up to 104, we accomplished.
105.
We're on 106.
105, we accomplished.
Yeah, 106, you're on.
106.
So we're on 106. Okay. We're trying here, we're trying.
Still too many.
No.
We're flying.
Busy guy.
You know, if Green Bay was playing, you'd be doing a lot quicker.
Oh, Green Bay.
They're done.
They're done.
Green Bay's not playing.
I don't know. Al gave me a little hope. He said that conference is all
shaky. That conference is all
shaky. Yeah, so it was four in a row.
Okay, resolution 106 to approve the stipulation of settlement consenting to the reduction of the assessment roll for 2016. Supervisor Lanzetta proposed the following. Whereas real property tax assessment review proceeding was commenced by Highway Properties Corp. regarding a vacant parcel situated on Route 9W, Marlborough, New York. You all know where that is, right? It's right behind
Stewart's.
Stewart's. To review its assessment for tax year 2016, and whereas the tax assessment for the premises for tax year 2016 was $114,500, and whereas the stipulation will require a refund of taxes to the petitioner for the year 2016, and now therefore be resolved that the town of Marlborough Town Board hereby approves the stipulation of settlement as set forth in the consent judgment annexed hereto as Schedule A, an original taxable assessment to excess of what the taxes would have been if the assessment had been fixed as determined in Schedule A. Be it further resolved that the town of Marlborough supervisor and or the assessor and their attorney Daniel J. Russ take necessary steps to officiate the settlement and refund the said monies to the petitioner.
Only question I have on this before we vote, and okay. I maybe should have looked this up before the meeting, but does that have site plan approval for any project?
No.
Because they weren't from the planning.
What are you talking about?
The Larkin property.
Behind Stewart's. Stewart's.
Right behind Stewart's.
Yeah.
The one they used to take, they've been taking the shale and stuff out of there for a while.
That's the one that Chris Wham addressed
yeah,
in his thing. It's
right.
Chris Larkin. It has site plan approval, but since expired,
he wants it.
All right, so the site plan has expired and it's now vacant land.
Yeah,
basically.
Remember back in the day, we got rid of exemptions.
Yeah.
So I guess one of the planning board members, they thought maybe felt sorry for the guy. He did a motion, but he didn't get a second. So the other six board members said no. Essentially, you're not going to get an extension. Either you're going to do the project or, you know, you start from the beginning.
Now. I got you.
You start from the beginning.
So because of that, now it's considered vacant land.
Right.
Gotcha. That was my
right
question.
Back to the planning board.
I thought he had approval for something.
An approved site plan that got extensions over the years has ceased to happen at the last planning board meeting, so it no longer has planning board approval.
Gotcha.
It would start from scratch.
So he's now back to vacant.
Yeah.
That was my only question.
Yeah. But did that make it too long?
What's it? No, that's the explanation I wanted, because I was pretty sure that he had gotten everything approved.
Code book says
gotcha.
You know, after approval, you have to start within one, finish within two.
Gotcha. I just wanted to make sure that was
Colley?
All done.
Councilman Corcoran?
Yes.
Councilman Molinelli?
Yes.
Councilman Koenig?
Yes.
Supervisor Lanzetta?
Yes. Okay. Now it's on the back. Resolution 107 to reappoint a member to the Board of Ethics. Supervisor Lanzetta proposes the following. Whereas Elizabeth Mannion wishes to continue serving on the Town of Marlborough Ethics Board, be it resolved that Elizabeth Mannion be reappointed as a member to the Board of Ethics with a term date ending December 31st, 2021, and moves for its adoption.
Councilman Corcoran?
Yes.
Councilman Molinelli?
Yes.
Councilman Koenig?
Yes.
Supervisor Lanzetta?
Yes. Thank you, Elizabeth. Resolution 108 to replace light on Dock Road in Milton Lighting District. Supervisor Lanzetta proposes the following, where it has been called to the attention of the town board that a light at the end of the Dock Road is defective. And whereas members of the town board met with representatives of Central Hudson and arranged for the replacement, be it resolved that the Marlborough Town Board approves of the removal of the lamp on pole 19885 and the replacement with a metal halide lamp.
Halide lamp.
Is they could put a LED down there?
Scott, well, yeah. She told us it was going to be a little too much, right? Is what happened?
Well, she's going to put the LED, but she wasn't going to put the one with the highest power, yeah. The LED. She's going to put the mid-range one.
Yeah.
Because we don't want it. It can't be overpowered because it'll be dental. Go on to the trains, and we don't want to.
And for the traffic.
We just want to make enough that the corner lights up and the landing sign gets lit. So
she.
She knows. And they can angle. She says she's actually going to have.
So it's going to be the halide.
Is that the one? Yeah.
Lamp.
Yeah.
Is that the old one? Yeah. That's the old ones that we use now?
Well, I think that's just the style.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's the Cobra.
Oh, it's Cobra types.
Oh, and yeah. It has an LED?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Like kind of like the ones over here.
Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Yep.
Good move. And moves for its adoption.
Councilman Corcoran.
Yes.
Councilman Molinelli.
Yes.
Councilman Koenig.
Yes.
Supervisor Lanzetta.
Yes. Okay. This is a resolution 109 to make 2017 budget amendments. Supervisor Lanzetta proposes the following, whereas the following budget amendments need to be made. Basically, a lot of the sewer district, the drainage districts were changed according to Pat Hines' report, and also some personnel changes were made. So it's very minimal, and as you could see, everybody sees this. Mm-hmm. So, and it moves for its adoption.
Okay. Councilman Corcoran?
Yes.
Councilman Molinelli?
Yes.
Councilman Koenig?
Yes.
Supervisor Lanzetta?
Yes. And with that being said, resolution 110 to adopt the 2017 budget as amended. Supervisor Lanzetta proposes the following, whereas the 2017 town Marlborough budget was adopted on October the 24th, 2016, and whereas some changes needed to be made, now therefore be resolved that the 2017 final budget is hereby adopted.
Councilman Corcoran?
Yes.
Councilman Molinelli?
Yes.
Councilman Koenig?
Yes.
Supervisor Lanzetta?
Yeah, and with this change, it's really very small. We're still under the cap. The changes as far as, you know, with the house of 400,000, it's only pennies. So it's not a big change.
Jarrell Adams, what that is.
That being said, all the resolutions done, right? And
I make a motion to
adjourn.
I'll second.
I will second that. Right. The Giants just scored.
Yep.
And I'll say
7-0. That'll be the only touchdown they get.
Six for six.
Thank you, everybody.
That's raining. Really, it's like the Jets. First three games, I started in the